Welcome to the STEM Coding Project. This is our Hour of Code submission. I'm Chris Orban.
My name is Demetrius Tuggle.
And we're here to talk about the physics of video games. I love video games. What about you?
I love video games.
Okay, what are the different types of games that you play?
Let's start with fighting games.
Fighting games.
There is also real-time strategy games.
Real-time, like what?
StarCraft 2.
StarCraft 2, that's a good one. What about first-person shooter games?
Yes, very, very popular.
There's a lot of those.
There's also role-playing games.
Role-playing games. Sports games.
And there is one more category of games. Racing games!
Okay, now I have to get something off my chest, Demetrius.
What is that?
I'm a physics professor at Ohio State University, and I pay very close attention to the physical accuracy of the games, and I have some bad news.
What's that bad news?
The physics of Mario Kart is terrible.
Mario Kart is one of the greatest games ever.
But the physics is awful.
I don't care what you say. It's still a great game.
Okay, it's just if you watch it, it's bad, okay? Do you want me to show you?
Prove it.
All right, here we go. So here is Mario Kart. We're gonna watch this. This is the sub-coaster level, Mario Kart 8. And I'm gonna show you, so let's kind of take a step back here so we can watch this thing. I'm gonna show you the physics is not so good. Now, sometimes it's hard to notice. You kind of have to watch it pretty closely to notice.
Okay.
But sometimes in the racing games, like if you hit the side, that'll kind of like nudge you forward. So that's one way that the physics isn't perfectly right. Sometimes when you slide, it's almost like sliding helps, whereas in real life, if your car starts sliding, you're about to crash.
Sure.
Now we're gonna go from air into water. What just happened?
We're still going the same speed.
Still going the same speed. Now we're going from water to air.
And we're still going the same speed.
Still going the same speed. And then we're gonna go into water again.
And we're still going the same speed.
And they're still going the same speed. Is that realistic?
No, but it's fun.
It's fun. We all agree that it's fun. It's just that it's not physically risky.
No.
You would have to slow down if you're going from air, which is a low density medium, into water, high density medium, and vice versa. That's what would happen in real life.
Yes,
if that, you had a lake that you were driving through in a racing game.
If you're always going through a lake, you will stop.
Okay.
Right.
My other pet peeve with Mario Kart is that Kart is spelled C-A-R-T. Not K-R-T. We all know this. It's the elephant in the room.
Yeah, well, okay. It's clever.
So. Maybe I'll give them a pass on that one.
Yes, they deserve a pass.
Now, there's some games that do it a lot better. So this is one of my favorite games. It's called the Next Car Game. And
okay.
They really went out of their way to try to get the physics right. And so if you just kind of watch this game,
okay,
what they use is they use something called a particle system. In a particle system, you have all these objects that are interacting with each other in a physically realistic way. So you have forces, momentum, acceleration, torques, things like that.
Yes.
And they all do it just realistically. Watch this. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, wow.
That's way better than Mario Kart.
Sure. The physics are accurate. The game.
I love it.
The physics are accurate.
I love it. Well, I think it's beautiful. All right. Another game that I love is called BeamNG Drive. I think this is on the Steam store if you want to look it up. And what they did is they took basically the same kind of a code that these car companies would use to simulate a car crash, you know, because they have to do that to make sure that everything's safe and for the passengers inside if there is an accident.
Oh, wow.
And they took all that physics, all that metal deformation physics and interactions and things like that, and put it in a video game.
Oh, this is really cool.
And so you can drive cars, you can, you know, fly planes and things like that, and it's all totally physically realistic. I salute you, BeamNG Drive. This is the most beautiful thing in a video game that I have ever seen.
This is a very accurate game, I will admit. It's very, very realistic.
Okay. Here's a question. All right, Angry Birds. Right.
Yes, yes.
Is the physics of Angry Birds accurate or not? Let's take a look. Watch this. What do you think?
I think it's very accurate.
That's actually correct. They actually did a really good job in Angry Birds to try to get the physics right. It's actually quite realistic, except for the fact that there's talking birds and pigs that you put into a slingshot.
Well, that is still a very fun part of the game, though.
Right. So we actually, in the STEM coding project, we use the same library that they use in Angry Birds to have multi-object collisions in some of our exercises. So I'm excited about that. Here's our version of Angry Birds. Not quite as fun, but what you can see is when we launch the bird, we like to show the velocity vector and the acceleration and the force vector. And so that's kind of one of the main things that we do when we talk about the physics of video games, is all we do is we just paste on these vectors, and you can think about the physics behind it without really thinking too hard about it.
Okay, sure.
So pretty easy. Right, now here's another question. All right, what's the problem with this game?
It looked like it was made before I was born.
Okay. When were you born?
97.
Oh my goodness. This game is from 1996.
Oh, wow.
Demetrius was born. Now there's a problem with this game.
Oh, wow.
There's a problem with the physics of this game.
Okay.
If you look closely, you can see it.
Well, the water seemed a little bit funny.
That's actually, yeah, you're actually on the right track. So did you see how they just jumped over that wave?
Yeah.
And how the jet skis interact with the wave, but the wave doesn't really interact with the jet skis?
Yeah.
That's because the wave is all pre-rendered. It's not actually what would happen in real life. If you interact with a wave like that in real life, you're going to sort of make a dent in that wave.
Yeah.
But they had to kind of take a shortcut, because in 1996, the year before Demetrius was born, they didn't have the kind of CPU power properly render the water in the game. Here's kind of water more recently, so some games with some better water. So that looks pretty nice there. You got a ship there. I don't know if that's pre-rendered or not. Maybe that one's pre-rendered too. This is more of an actual game. Here's like kind of the modern jet ski game. And sometimes you can see that they're doing a really good job. Clearly they're doing a better job, but still in a lot of cases it seems like they've pre-rendered it so that the objects are interacting with the waves, but the waves aren't really interacting with the objects.
Right.
So the purpose of sort of bringing all of this up is to ask the questions, what are the games that you play and how realistic are the physics in those games? And maybe they do a really good job, or maybe they do a really Mario Kart job.
Well,
So think about that for a second before you start our first coding exercise. Think about the physics in the video games that you play. How accurate are they, or how inaccurate?